What's up, guys? If you want to get cool items like this, or this, then check out the official Nuclear Reactions merch store, Ye Olde Nuclear Shop. The link to that will be in the description below. So if you really like the channel, if you really like this content, definitely check it out. I'm Blake X, and this is another Nuclear Reaction. What's up, survivors? The doom metal journey is continuing. Now, we are halfway through the month of December, a little bit more than half, actually, at this time. And so the doom metal journey, unfortunately, is going to come to an end soon. I'm going to finish out the month with it, and then a new journey is going to start in January. But it's been a fun ride so far, man. I've gotten turned on to a lot of really good bands, a lot of really good songs. There's one or two bands that I've already reacted to that I'm going to be revisiting, ideally, before this journey ends. So there's plenty of good stuff on the way, still in this month, plenty of good stuff to check out. By no means is the doom metal journey over yet. So today, I'm going to be checking out Swallow the Sun, which was requested by Bobby Hernandez, and the song Cathedral Walls. Now, this says featuring Annette Olsen. I'm not sure if this is the Annette from Nightwish. Could it be? And in that case, I don't know if you guys follow my Nightwish journey, but I just left the Taria phase, and when I do my next Nightwish reaction, I'm going to be moving on to the Annette era. I don't know if this is the same Annette. It might not be the same person at all, but if so, this will be the first time ever hearing her sing. But if not, anyway, it'll just be interesting to see what kind of guest vocalist this band has. I don't believe I've heard this band before. I checked Last.fm, I checked Spotify to see if I played them before, had them in any of my libraries. I don't think that I do. However, I am going to be seeing this band in May in Joliet, which is just outside of Chicago. And the band opening up for them is Infected Rain, one of my all-time favorite bands. Hopefully, I'm going to be able to meet the band again when I'm there. And so that's going to be an awesome experience. And it'll be cool to see Swallow the Sun play live for the first time. So in order to really have a full appreciation of that, I need to hear some of their songs first, obviously. So Cathedral Walls, as far as I know, is going to be my very first reaction and introduction to this band. It's over 6.5 minutes long, so I think we're just going to get to it. And the usual, hope everyone's doing well out there. My roommate is gone as of right now, so I have the place to myself. So I'm hoping that that means I'm going to be a lot more productive and be able to get a lot of content out for you guys, including some stuff that I have planned for Patreon. Some interesting little side videos, not necessarily reactions, but just videos about different things. Also, by the way, I keep forgetting to mention this, but I do have an official website and blog. It's called www.blakedep.com. I'll leave the link below in the description. And basically, I do all kinds of different stuff there. I do like written album reviews. I do writing about writing tips and writing styles because I'm also a writer and an aspiring book writer. So I write about that kind of stuff as well. I'm going to be writing about travel in the future, just doing personal blog entries, just personal day-to-day experiences, a nice variety of different stuff. So it's going to be a little bit of everything. So if you want to check out my writing and read some of my blog posts, check out that link. Also, if you want to become a patron for as low as $2 a month and get access to some special exclusive bonus content, check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. Check out the merch store, Ye Olde Nuclear Shop, and the Facebook group, The Mushroom Cloud. All these things will also be linked in the description. It's a great way to show your support for the channel and to enhance your experience as a member of the nuclear family. Okay. Cathedral Walls by Swallow the Sun. I have the lyrics up. Thank you, Metal Archives. And it'll be good to hear some more doom metal. All right. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1, go. You know what's interesting? Sorry to pause it so early on, but just something I was really quickly thinking about. This intro to the song, this instrumental work right here, it sounds very good, by the way, so far, but it sounds more like an outro to me. Like, it sounds like the final instrumental track you'll hear on an album to close out the record. That's like the vibe that I'm getting from it. So that's very interesting that they're starting the song with, for me anyway, as a listener, a kind of vibe and energy of, like, you know, something ending. And maybe that was intentional. I don't know if that connects to the lyrics, or that's just my weird brain, you know, interpreting things in its own weird way. So that's totally possible. But anyway, it's just a little crazy thought that I had that I wanted to share. Liking it so far. Can't wait to see where it goes. Let's continue. I like the vocals so far. It has a very gothic kind of feeling to it. I really love the female vocals here. So yeah, I'm just going to pause once more. I just want to say I really appreciate the female voice in this. I got to just give me 1 second. Let me Google it really quick. I know I don't usually do that during the song itself, but I just have to find out. Annette Olsen. If she's the Annette from Nightwish. Annette Olsen. Yeah, Swedish singer, best known as the former lead vocalist of Finnish symphonic metal band Nightwish. Holy shit. So I'm getting introduced to her voice sooner than I expected. Pony will love that. you know what? Like, I know she's not really the most popular vocalist out of the three Nightwish vocalists, but I really, really like her voice in this one, at least. It's like very small and childlike, but also very rich and very, very captivating and very emotional, I would even say. And it goes perfectly with this music and with the sound of the song. So I think I really am enjoying her voice so far. I just got to say that. Also enjoying the male vocals very much. Like I said, very much giving me a gothic metal feel. I'm not quite getting the doom metal feeling yet. And maybe this isn't really a doom metal song. I don't know. I do know that these guys are doom metal partly. They also do a little bit of death doom and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm really enjoying this one so far. I like the atmosphere. I like the slow pace and the slow buildup of this. All good things, man. So let's keep it going. There's the fucking death doom. You know what this reminds me of? With the vocals and the guitar right here? This reminds me of the song The Grand Conjuration by Opus. Anyway, really enjoying this so far. That's drumming. This is good. This is so amazing. I love this. Love that atmosphere, man. All right. I'm fucking sold. Can't wait to see Swallow the Sun in May. I hope they play this song live, but it's probably a popular song because I think this is a newer song of theirs. I'm not sure when this... 2012, okay. Melodic Death Doom Metal. Yeah, I can see it. So this is probably a popular song by them, so maybe they will play it, but I just don't... Obviously, I don't think they're going to have Annette there at the show doing guest vocals. I'm not sure how that one's going to work or if they would even play that song in their set. But anyway, it does get me excited to hear more from this band and to see them live in a few months. It says here, Annette Olsen Bleicher, vocals on Cathedral Walls. Now I know she's from Nightwish. Wow. I really enjoyed her voice once again. I thought that was one of the best parts of the song. I think I enjoyed the male voice. And the atmosphere was great. There were some really good parts with the drumming. The guitar was good. Really a lot of exceptional stuff going on here in the song. I do have some criticisms, however small they may be. One criticism is that I felt that the buildup, the slow kind of quiet buildup, which I very much liked, and I very much liked how it switched from calm to heavy death doom out of nowhere. That caught me off guard, as you saw. But I wish that it didn't take quite as long to get to that transition period. Like, I wish that we had heard that chorus with Annette's vocals and the heavy parts and the harsh vocals a little bit more in this song, which leads me to my second criticism, which is that with this song, even though it's almost 7 minutes long, I think this actually could have been an 8 or 9 minute long song because it was just that good. And so even though those two criticisms are kind of small, they really do affect the song for me as a listener. And it kind of sucks because this is a really good song. There's so much going on here that's really enjoyable and that really captivated me and pulled me in. And for that reason, it's kind of regrettable that we didn't hear that part with Annette a few more times. It was worth hearing a few more times. They should have came back to that a little bit more. I was really enjoying that part especially. And it was regrettable that we didn't hear the harsh vocals utilized more in this one. Now, this was just one of many songs by Swallow the Sun, and it was a great, great song, don't get me wrong. Like I said, I enjoyed literally everything else about this. I have nothing else to criticize, but those are my two nitpicks. And they do affect, you know, my overall interpretation and takeaway of the song, but nevertheless, I really enjoyed listening to it. This was a great experience. This is going to be a playlist song, and I'm going to re-listen to this one after I stop filming, because I got to hear this again, man. And this also makes me excited to get to the Annette era of Nightwish. Like, I had never heard her before, so I couldn't really say one way or the other how her voice was. I've had a few people tell me that they didn't enjoy her voice quite as much. I've had a few people tell me that she was the weakest out of the three vocalists in Nightwish. So I have to see for myself, man, because so far, I don't know. I mean, I'll check out Nightwish with Annette on vocals and see how I feel then, you know, before I, you know, have a stronger opinion. I'll just put it that way. But it does get me excited to hear something from the Annette era. I don't know, man. I liked what I heard in this one. So if this was the first taste of her voice and her style, I'm all for it. So yeah, that's pretty much my opinion on the song. Let me get to the lyrics. Okay, where do we go from here when these words have been unspoken? We carry this burden through the gentle summer rain. The convoy is still and weeping, yet I don't feel anything but these walls around. And the candles on cathedral walls chase the weak light under the saint's eyes. Over you and your shattered words, for the ones you lost. In your mourning, you're alone, so alone. This silence speaks a million words, words of comfort so shallow. How I wish even for one tear, but for my heart it's too late. Where do I go when the sorrow turns to hate? Where do I go from here? The guardian angels, quiet and near, slowly turning away, for hell is surely here. Every step towards the hole in the ground I rot, carrying your white coffin. White coffin, my heart wide shut. I will follow you earth to earth. I will follow you ashes to ashes. I will follow you dust to dust. I will follow you. How I wish even for one tear, but for my heart, it's too late when sorrow turns to hate. In your mourning, you're alone, so alone. Nice, cheerful song. I think it's very positive and uplifting. We need more songs like this. No, seriously, I enjoyed what the lyrics had to say here. So in typical doom metal fashion, this is a song about grief. What's interesting, one of the interesting things about songs, I should say, when they deal with the same topics as other songs that I break down on this channel, or which I have broken down previously, and reacted to, is finding how the perspective in each of these songs is different from the other. Because when it comes to grief and mourning, obviously people process that in a very different way, depending on your personality type. And whenever you do that, and if you're grieving as a writer, and you put yourself into that song, and you put your own emotional energy into that song, that's obviously going to be reflected in the lyrics. So I think I've dealt with songs that cover being very angry during grief, ones that deal with being in shock. But this is one that has its own sort of spin on it. And I feel that the person in these lyrics, maybe even the writer of these lyrics, is in a different kind of headspace here. And there are several lines in particular. Go away, Papa. Fucking annoying. Anyway, yeah, there are some lines here in particular that jump out to me because they kind of put unique imagery in your head. One of them was, I was just talking about it. Am I getting tired here? carrying your white coffin, your eyes wide shut. That immediately interested me, white coffin. So I was reading this thing about dream interpretation, okay? And I often have very vivid, lucid dreams. I also suffer from sleep paralysis once in a while. So understanding dreams and researching dreams, that's always been very interesting to me as a subject and as something to learn more about and educate myself on. And I was reading about how different things that appear in a dream can be based on different things, depending on the color, or they can mean different things, is probably a better way to put it. You know, there's different imagery, and it all symbolizes different things, psychologically speaking. And this might just be totally bogus, I don't know. It was just something that I read. I haven't researched it fully, I could be wrong about this, but it just caught me as interesting. So, like a coffin, for instance, if it's black in your dream, I think it resembles depression or represents depression. And if it's white, I think it represents a loss of innocence. Hopefully I didn't mix up those two. But yeah, I gave it my best shot. But anyway, I honestly don't know if that's what they were going for here with the mention of white coffin. This is just my take on it, you know. But if you think about it, never feeling grief is, I think, its own kind of innocence in a way. And I think it's a rare thing for a lot of people to never feel grief because that's, you know, obviously death is a part of life. Although I'll go as far as to say that I don't think I've experienced grief yet because I've said this in another video, but for those who don't know, I was never really close with my extended family. A lot of them turned me away when I needed help. They were not very kind people or very good people, at least not to me. And so when I heard or read about some of them passing away, I didn't really feel grief because I just didn't have that connection with them beforehand. I'm sure I felt some sense of loss and sense of sadness, maybe even regret that, you know, they couldn't be forthright enough and, you know, good enough people to kind of try and reconcile with me or, you know, to reach out to me, you know. So that was saddening, if I'm being perfectly honest. But that's something that I think they should have regretted much more than I, because I was always nice to them and I never did anything to hurt them. And a few of them pretty blatantly judged me and turned me away when I needed help the most. And, you know, hey, I got by and I survived, so I'm not whining or complaining. But just speaking to them as people, to kind of explain a little bit of background of what I'm talking about here, that's why when they kind of passed away, I just didn't feel a sense of grief because I didn't have that close connection to them. So I haven't experienced grief yet, but unfortunately, there are people in my life that I am really close with, and I don't want to lose them, of course. That's a natural feeling. Anybody would feel that way. You know, when you love somebody, you care about somebody, whether it's friends or, you know, whatever it may be. And, you know, obviously the day will come when you will lose someone close to you, so everyone is eventually going to feel grief. But I would say that not everyone has felt it yet. So for people who haven't felt that way yet, you know, it's, again, it is a sort of innocence because it's something that has affected a lot of people, but it hasn't affected you quite yet. So in a way, you're still kind of untouched in that department. It's interesting. So the person in this song may be seeing the death of this person as not only painful, but they may feel that they've lost their purity in a sense and just feel damaged and broken. You know, that's possible. Because note that it says here, how I wish even for one tear, keyword being wish. But for my heart, it's too late. And the "for my heart, it's too late" part, I think we can use to pretty much rule out shock, right? Because that would be another reason why you wouldn't cry for someone, you know, if you're still in shock over their death. But in this case, it may be because they feel too broken to even feel emotion anymore. You know, grief has taken something from them. And by something, I mean something more than just the person they lost. So, you know, I once heard someone say that grief is messy, or grieving is messy. And I thought that was a very interesting and very apt kind of way to put it, actually. You know, grief is messy. It sounds like a mess and it seems like a mess. You know, it's just, you're tangled up in so many emotions and you're second guessing so many things. I could just imagine. I'm someone who's very empathetic. So, you know, I don't know, man. It's just, it's got to be a hard thing to deal with and to get past. And, you know, I have some friends, actually, who deal with grief and who have dealt with grief. And, you know, my heart goes out to them, man. It's not a fun thing. And it breaks a lot of people. I've seen that too. One or two people, in fact. There was someone who helped me out several years ago who was dealing with grief, and it just hit him pretty badly. And he became a mess, you know. There's that word again, messy, you know. And he just kind of unspooled and unraveled, you know, little by little. And started, you know, being really self-destructive. Not purposefully, but because of what he was dealing with emotionally. He just couldn't grapple with it, couldn't get past it. And I'm not sure what he's doing now. Hopefully he got past that and, you know, he healed a little bit. You know, if you're out there, buddy, I'm sending you good vibes, good energy. Wish you all the best, man. But, you know, not fun shit, that's for sure. You know, so when the day comes that I'm going to have to feel grief, I just, that's going to suck. But, you know, it's a part of life, you know, as is everything. And we deal with it and we all deal with it in a different way. And that's what makes it interesting to talk about, you know, as a song lyric subject. So yeah, and the other parts of the song that pop out to me are the ones that reference religion here. Like, obviously the song is called Cathedral Walls. So this may also be about interpreting the pain of grief as proof that religion, you know, holds no deeper meaning or purpose, because it's clearly not helping this person, right? Again, it says, "The guardian angels, quiet and near, slowly turning away." So when it says toward the end, "You're alone, so alone," I think that's not only referencing no longer being with the person that you love anymore. I mean, I'm sure that's part of it, but also being alone in the sense of there being no God or no angels for comfort, at least in the mind of this person. It's the loss of faith through grief, essentially. And maybe that even directly ties into the perceived loss of innocence, because in a way, you could see these kinds of spiritual beliefs as being innocent, depending on your perspective. Certainly secularists, for example, would say that those types of beliefs and practices don't hold up to reality and to science, and therefore they'd relegate religion as a whole and the beliefs and tenets that it entails to the stuff of childish fantasy, you know, so they would probably consider it to have a certain innocence of its very own. So, you know, maybe that's a stretch. It's just my interpretation, but that could be a possibility. And by the way, I don't agree with that sentiment totally. I think spirituality has its merits. I have a religion that I practice, and but that's another conversation for another time. And I've talked about that, you know, ad infinitum anyway. So, you know, go back and check out some of my other videos. There's plenty of them where I talk about that. Basically, I think we can conclude that this person is giving up on their faith, and the cathedral walls around them just feel cold and hollow. You know, so grief is one thing, right? But it's also interesting to me how a lot of doom metal, after I've explored it for these past 3 months, it's interesting to me with this genre how so many songs seem to touch upon religion in their own way, you know, whether it's questioning the validity of religion or being pro-spirituality or even using religious themes or concepts in the lyrics. That's very interesting to me. That's definitely something that has stuck out and that I've noticed about doom metal. And I don't know. I don't know what the reason is for that. Maybe some doom metal experts can fill me in the comments, but I never realized this genre did that so much, you know. I could see that obviously for black metal, right? Very spiritual music a lot of the time. A lot of the time, very anti-Christian, picking apart religion in general. So black metal, of course, no-brainer. Even thrash metal, if you're making social commentary and religion is part of that, sure, you know. But doom metal, that caught me off guard a little bit. That's interesting. It's not a bad thing, of course. In fact, I think it's a topic totally worth diving into in different ways and in different genres. So that's cool. But it just, again, surprised me. More so than the grief thing, because that makes sense. You know, grief and melancholy, it's doom metal. So yeah, Cathedral Walls, very good musically. I have my little gripes about it that I mentioned. But aside from that, very, very good song. Very enjoyable. Love the voice of Annette so far, based on this one song that I've heard. Gonna explore more of her vocals and her style. We'll see if I become an Annette fan. But so far, very much appreciating that. And of course, I can't write off the male vocals by any means. They were just as good. Both the cleans and the harshes. Really, really great stuff musically, aside from those small criticisms that I mentioned. And again, I really do wish the song had been a little bit longer, because it's frustrating when you enjoy something about a song and then it just ends, you know, and it's like, ah, shit, you know, you just wanted it to go on for a little bit longer. So my criticism is that I like it so much that there should have been more of it, basically. And lyrically, you know, not super amazing poetry, but very well written regardless, and deals with something very real and in its own way, which I appreciate. So that was cool as well. So those two things being considered together, I'm going to give this one, I gotta be fair, I'm gonna give this one a very strong 10 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. Yeah, could be an 11. Again, if it was a little longer, and if they utilize more female vocals, you guys know that I'm really into that. I really enjoy and appreciate the beauty and the sound of the female voice, especially in metal. So that's something that's always going to get me, you know, unless it's a really horrible, untalented singer. That's always going to be a highlight for me, more or less, from a metal song. But you guys probably know that by now. Anyway, that's one less doom metal request. There's still a handful more to go, plus my own picks on this journey. And once again, this journey will continue for the next couple of weeks. And that is over, and we're moving on. So I'm going to try and get to as much as I can, as soon as I can. Thank you, Bobby Hernandez, for the request. And that is all I got for you guys. Thank you so much for the support. As always, much love and respect to the Nuclear family. Don't forget to subscribe. All it takes is one click. Thank you to those who have subscribed. Thank you to all the supporters. Thank you to everyone who checks out the merch store, to all my patrons. It never goes unappreciated. And that's about it. So the doom metal journey will continue, but it's ending soon. So stay tuned for more. I will catch you guys on the next one.